Welcome to the seventh Sunday of Pentecost. My name is Pastor Christy, and I am so glad to be able to join with you this beautiful Sunday as we fellowship with one another. We may not be able to join in a building, but we are able to join one another because wherever we are, the Spirit is with us. So I welcome you to Point of Grace on this Sunday, July 19th. It is so good to be with you today.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose steadfast love is everlasting, whose faithfulness endures from generation to generation. Amen. Trusting in the mercy of God, let us confess our sin. Reconciling God, we confess that we do not trust your abundance, and we deny your presence in our lives. We place our hope in ourselves and rely on our own efforts. We fail to believe that you provide enough for all. We abuse your good creation for our own benefit. We fear difference and do not welcome others as you have welcomed us. We sin in thought, word, and deed. By your grace, forgive us. Through your love, renew us, and in your Spirit, lead us, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life. Amen. Beloved of God, by the radical abundance of divine mercy, we have peace with God through Christ Jesus, through whom we have obtained grace upon grace. Our sins are forgiven. Let us live now in hope, for hope does not disappoint, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Sweetness of the wet grass.
of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always. And also with you. Please join me in the prayer of the day. Faithful God, most merciful Judge, you care for your children with firmness and compassion. By your Spirit, nurture us who live in your kingdom, that we may be rooted in the way of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The first reading is from Isaiah, the 44th chapter. Thus says the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts. I am the first, and I am the last. Besides me, there is no God. Who is like me? Let them proclaim it. Let them declare and set it forth before me. Who has announced from of old the things to come? Let them tell us what is yet to be. Do not fear or be afraid. Have I not told you from of old and declared it? You are my witnesses. Is there any God besides me? There is no other rock. I know not one. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Psalm 86.
Teach me your way, O Lord, and I will walk in your truth. Give me an undivided heart to revere your name.
I will thank you, O Lord my God, with all my heart, and glorify your name forevermore.
For great is your love toward me. You have delivered me from the pit of death.
The arrogant rise up against me, O God, and a band of violent people seeks my life. They have not set you before their eyes.
But you, O Lord, are gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and full of kindness and truth.
Turn to me and have mercy on me. Give your strength to your servant and save the child of your handmaid.
Show me a sign of your favor, so that those who hate me may see it and be put to shame, because you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me.
The second reading is from Paul's letter to the Romans, the 8th chapter. So then, brothers and sisters, we are debtors not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if in fact we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now, and not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we groan inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we are saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, for who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God.
Alleluia, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia, alleluia.
Please join me in the reading of our Gospel from St. Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus put before the crowds another parable. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to someone who sowed good seeds in his field. But while everyone was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared as well. And the slaves of the householder came and said to him, Master, did you not sow good seeds in your field? Where then did these weeds come from? He answered, An enemy has done this. The slaves said to him, Then do you want us to go and gather them? But he replied, No. For in gathering the weeds, you would uproot the wheat along with them. Let both of them grow together until the harvest, and at harvest time, I will tell the reapers, collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but gather the wheat into my barn. Then he left the crowds and went into the house, and the disciples approached him, saying, Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field. He answered, The one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seeds are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the kingdom of the evil one, and the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are the angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so it will be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and all evildoers, and they will throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Let anyone with ears listen. The Gospel according to Matthew. Praise to you, O Christ.
Hi, children of God. How are you today? We're going to do our story in a little bit different area today. So come along with me.
Today,
We're going to tell our story in the garden. And our story today is called The Parable of the Sower and the Weeds. This story looks like it could be a parable. It's gold. Gold is very valuable. A parable is even more valuable than all the gold in the world. It looks like a present. A parable is a present. A present given to you before you were even born. Before your grandparents and their grandparents were born. And sometimes a parable has a lid. They can be hard to get into. But if you keep coming back, one day it will open. There once was a man who did such wonderful things and said such amazing things that people wondered who he was, and they often followed him. And when they followed him, he often talked about the kingdom of heaven. And when he talked about this kingdom, it was not like a kingdom that they'd heard of before. It wasn't like the kingdom they lived in or any kingdom they visited. What could this kingdom of heaven be? And one day they asked the man, "What is this kingdom of heaven?" And he said, "The kingdom of heaven is like when a sower, a person who plants seeds, goes out and plants good seed. But in the night, while he is asleep, an enemy sows weeds into the good seed. And as the plants begin to grow, the weeds also grow. And the workers come to the sower to tell him, 'Didn't you plant good seed in the garden? Where did these weeds come from?' And the sower answers, 'An enemy has done this.' And the workers ask, 'Shall we go pull the weeds?' And the sower says, 'No. Let them grow together. And when it's time for harvest, pull the weeds first and bundle them and throw them into the fire. And then go and harvest the good seed and put it in the barn.' I wonder who this sower could really be. I wonder how he felt when he was planting the good seed. I wonder if the enemy had a name. I wonder how the sower felt when he heard the weeds were growing along his good seed. I wonder what he planted. I wonder what he did while his plants grew and grew. I wonder what the sower did with the harvest he put in his barn.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always, and also with you. Let us pray. Gracious God, we come to this day placing our hope and trust in you, knowing that only you can heal our wounds, heal our hearts, and heal our minds. This day I come to you seeking that you use the words to speak peace to those who are hurting, and those who are weary, to give rest. Open our hearts, open our ears, and open our minds, and help us to love one another. In your name I pray. Amen. Lately, it has been really hard to love my neighbor. And I had to ask myself this week, why? And I've come to the conclusion that it is from not being able to worship together, not being able to receive hugs, not being able to see loved ones, and just the constant stresses that it feels like I'm in a pressure cooker sometimes. And my top is just rattling. And that, I've noticed, makes it hard to reach out to one another. So I'm worn down, not only spiritually, but mentally, emotionally, and physically. They all are connected with one another. And part of what is kind of pressure cooking, you could say, is the actions and reactions of those around us and around me to the reality of what we've been living in. Those who refuse or are unwilling to accept this reality. And that makes me tired. It makes me tired having to not necessarily defend, but to say, this is where I'm at. So I'd like to look at who is my neighbor. And I'd like to expand that and expand my context of who I consider my neighbor to include all human life on the planet. In looking at the parable, looking at those who are sown amongst us. And it's important to have a broader view of who's sown amongst us than we might normally have. And consider that perhaps we're not seeing whom our neighbors are. It's not as clear-cut as we once thought, because the field is a gorgeous color. And thinking, kind of connecting the thoughts, is when we put signs or we shout, love your neighbor as yourself, or all lives matter, or Black Lives Matter, who are we thinking that includes? Are we thinking that it's those whose values and goals align or look like our own? Or those who don't? The readings say that we're not the sower and we don't get to decide those who are bundled with us and those who are separated like the tares, the weeds. We are the seed that has been sowed. Last week, it was the seeds that were sown was the message from Christ, the word of God. And we were the dirt and what kind of soil and what kind of our roots were going to be. But this week, it's that we're the seed. And I am thankful that I am not God. I am not the sower this week. I am not the spirit. and I am not Christ. I do not have any control about who was sown. I don't know what others' hearts may be like. I just know my own. And I'm responsible to keep sowing the seed from the parable from last week, sowing the seed of the good news. And it's beyond our control of who is sown next to us. It's how we gain that assurance and the strength to engage those who are our neighbors. Most importantly, knowing our own hearts. What has been sown from the seeds that have been thrown into our own hearts? That's what we have to know. And second, we can hold on to and know that we are beloved children of God because we have been adopted by the Spirit. And third, we find assurance in God's promises. I absolutely love the idea and the theology that we have been called by the Spirit, we have been healed, and we've been sealed in the baptism with Christ. And the wind that we see of the Spirit is moving. And it's the wind of change. And change can be scary. Change can be uncomfortable. We're just to open the windows and the doors and let the Spirit move and blow through. That is what separates the wheat from the tares. When it gets tossed up in the combines and turned around, the wind is what separates. And moving back now, kind of into our week, I challenge each of us to move as the wind of the Spirit blows change throughout the world. And the wind that blows through us and claims us and moves us closer to our neighbor. It's not separating us out. And the flesh that is causes our hearts to harden or put up barriers between us and God. God is calling us to open our hearts. To love our neighbor is to demonstrate and example God's love for us in our interactions. And trust me, I know it's hard sometimes. And it's understanding where our neighbor is coming from. Understanding their context, what influences them in their thinking, what is going on in their lives that have brought them to this point. And it's keeping our ears and our eyes and our hearts open when we'd rather shut them and guard them from the pain that surrounds us. And it's seeing our neighbor, those who we wouldn't naturally see as our neighbor, but those who stretch us and enrage us sometimes, and they are our neighbor. They are part of the all. When we say all are welcome, that means all our neighbors. Not the select few that we like to put in a nice little, oh, these people, we'll welcome these all. But it's all, because all are beloved and created in the image of God. And remembering that when it's difficult, because it often is when the Spirit is moving, that Creator God gives us strength, comforts us, and helps us. God, who is gracious and compassionate, who has proclaimed us and claimed us as beloved children. So hold on to that when we engage and talk about our neighbor. Amen.
With the whole church, let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Confident of your care and helped by the Holy Spirit, we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. God of the harvest, you sow the good seed of the gospel of Jesus Christ into your field. Help your church throughout the world to be both diligent and patient, full of resolve and gentleness, that our witness may be faithful to your intentions. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of all space and time, your whole creation groans in labor pains, awaiting the gift of new birth. Renew the earth, sky, and sea, so that all your creation experiences freedom from the bondage of decay. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of the nations, teach us your ways that we may walk in your truth. Mend the fabric of the human family, which is too often torn apart by our fearful and warring ways. Guide us by your mercy, grace, and steadfast love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of hope, you accompany those who suffer and are near to the brokenhearted. Open our hearts to your children who are lonely and abandoned, who feel trapped by despair, and all who suffer in any way. Especially we pray for Chris, Ashley, Bradley, Emery, Rick, Victoria, Paul and Regina, Doug, David Sr. and Gail and David Jr., Jan and Kurt, Shane and Christy and Kari, and all those working as chaplains or hospital caregivers, all refugee and immigrant families, Mary, Dick and Polly, Betty, Nancy, Joyce, Pat, Don and Valeria, Gail and Dale, Jim, Judy, Dave, Kim, Kristen, Janice, Bobby, and Adam. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of the seasons, in the midst of summer, give us refreshment, renewal, and new opportunities. We pray for the safety of those who travel. We pray for those who cannot take the rest they need. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of life, those who have died in you shine like the sun in your endless kingdom. We remember with thanksgiving the saints of all times and places and saints close to us. Gather us with them on the day of salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In the certain hope that nothing can separate us from your love, we offer these prayers to you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks. give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ his Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich because of what the Lord has done.
God of goodness and growth, all creation is yours, and your faithfulness is as firm as the heavens. Water and word, wine and bread, these are signs of your abundant grace. Nourish us through these gifts, that we might proclaim your steadfast love in our communities and in the world. Through Jesus Christ, our strength and our song. Amen.
Let us pray. Praise and thanks to you, Holy God, for by your word you made all things. You spoke light into darkness, called forth beauty from chaos, and brought life into being. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. By your word, you called your people Israel to tell of your wonderful gifts, freedom from captivity, water on the desert journey, a pathway home from exile, wisdom for life with you. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Through Jesus, your word made flesh, you speak to us and call us to witness forgiveness through the cross, life to those entombed by death, the way of your self-giving love. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Send your spirit of truth, O God. Rekindle your gifts within us. Renew our faith, increase our hope, and deepen our love for the sake of a world in need. Faithful to your word, O God, draw near to all who call on you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
All right, some brief announcements as we're wrapping up worship for today. The first one is there will be fellowship hour straight after this time. It will be at 10:30. The link should be the same one that we've been using. If not, it should be in your email, or if you can't find it, text one of us, and we'll be able to send you that link. The other bit is to keep looking at your grace notes for all the upcoming events and going ons in the church. The final announcement, and we'll be talking about it more during fellowship hour, is giving in Tithely, our wonderful online option of giving, since we're not able to give directly at church in the wonderful offering basket. There's directions in the grace notes, step-by-step of how to set up your Tithely account. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to anyone on the church council. They'd be happy to walk you through that. Call Kathy at our front office and she'd be happy also. I'm very glad that you were all able to join us today on this kind of hybrid Sunday. And I wish you the best for the rest of this week. Next, we'll be sending prayer and then a blessing. Thank you. Please join me in the sending prayer. Neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. God, the Creator, Jesus the Christ, and the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, bless you and keep you in eternal love. Amen.
The ground is sinking sand.
Go forth into the world to serve God with gladness. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor all people. Love and serve God, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. Thanks be to God.